Hi friends, firstly thanks a lot for the warm feedback, responses and requests. There are all kinds of requests that are coming in. Some of you want to know more about how to manage your careers and some of you want to know how being a woman it is at the workplace. So today I thought let me talk about being a woman at work or the biases that come across us at work. Yes, there's no shying away. There are biases at work that work against women. And there are a lot of reasons. Why do they happen? Firstly, it's social programming. You know, a lot of us who are in their 30s or 40s and even the younger generation, they've all grown up where women have been stereotyped in roles like teachers, nurses, hairdressers, you know, the softer roles which are more about nurturing and not so much about leading. They're not so much about asserting. So yes, for both men and women at work, there is this stereotype that they carry in their mind. Well, women are more the nurturers, they are soft, they cannot take hard calls. That's where, you know, the entire stereotyping or bias at work first starts. And then comes the woman herself. You know, somewhere a lot of us carry that in our heads that we are different. The minute you start feeling different or thinking about yourself as different from the crowd, different from the masses, your behavior changes and it might work against you. It might even create a bias that doesn't really exist, but you are carrying with yourself. There are a few other limiting behaviors that I have seen. Women often flock together. They'll go out for lunch and coffee together at workplace. They'll not mingle as much with the male counterparts. That limits your circle. Some of them also want to be treated differently with baby gloves. They'll have travel constraints. They will not speak up for the more challenging projects. And all this becomes a self-fulfilling prophecy where you continue to create that bias. Well, women are for softer roles. A woman cannot handle a tough assignment. She might not travel for long hours or she might not travel out of the city. There's one more self-limiting factor. That's a poor body image. A lot of us feel different simply because we look different. A lot of women as they're growing up develop a lot of complexes about their looks, about their figures. And then in an attempt to just fit in, sometimes they also try dressing differently. Probably some of them go to the extreme of dressing more like men. And some of them just go along and wear whatever they've been wearing outside work. They don't really know how to dress to work, what is right, what is wrong. And that can be disastrous. Firstly, I will say you don't have to start dressing like a man to fit in. Okay, let's be ourselves. We can continue to wear something that we are comfortable in, yet we don't stand out for the wrong reasons. I've often seen a lot of teenagers come to work wearing in clothes that scream for attention. Let's not wear these clothes. Like, we want to be standing out at work for the right reasons, for our work, right? For what we bring to the table, not for what we wear. There's so many choices available today, which are very comfortable for women, which give them a very corporate and formal yet comfortable look. So pick up a decent wardrobe where you'll stay comfortable through the day, yet fit in and not stand out for the wrong reasons. You know, unfortunately, all said and done, biases for women are at peak when women are in their 20s and 30s. That's rather unfortunate because these are also the years when most of the men and women are expected to really slog it out, give disproportionate time at work to build their careers, to gather experience and mature for more senior roles. So why does that happen? It stems from the fact that most corporates, most managers do look for a lot of stability at work. And what's happening in a woman's life during these years? There's marriage happening, which becomes the first derailer. There's maternity, there's childcare, and there's dual career conflict. These are the four things that happen naturally to a man and a woman, but often a woman goes through and gets impacted a lot more than her counterpart. And the best thing over here to really do is to have very honest conversations with your partner back at home. Create the right support mechanisms. Be very clear about what role does your career play for you and for your household. and to what level are you willing to sacrifice at work or at home to be where you really need to be. And then after you've had these conversations, after you are at peace, you know, you have to make some choices. You can't have your cake and eat it too. After you've done that, then have very honest conversations with your manager. Let him or her know this is how much you're willing to bring to the table. This is what you're open to. Do not confuse your manager. Once you commit to something, do that. So now let's say you've done everything right. You're not shy about being yourself. You're being as authentic as you can be. You're working really hard. You've got your career goals in place. Yet you feel that bias. Yet you feel that differentiation. And it happens. It's happened to me. It's happened to a lot of us. Where we are very clear, we are willing to commit to ourselves. Yet your manager feels, because you're a woman now with kids, you will not be able to perform in an assignment and you're denied that assignment. It might happen that you're just planning kids and you spill the news to your manager and a promotion that was due to you is passed to someone else. Again, it's something that's happened to me. It happens very commonly. So what is it that you can do? You know, what I've realized, just talking to your manager or HR or someone at work often doesn't help, because they've got so much going on. And yes, they do want to carry the image or put that image that, well, we are fair at work. They might give you 100 reasons that, no, we've been as fair and yeah, performance lag, so this was a small thing that you could have done and maybe better luck next time. So these are the times where having a support group outside work would help. You know, having some mentor, maybe within the organization but senior enough to influence things for you in the right direction. Have a chat with your manager that here's a person willing to commit. So don't let her gender come in the way, might help you. Sometimes, unfortunately, you might have to live with it and just work harder and let that phase of your life when you're going through maternity or childcare be a very small derailer for you. I'll only say, don't get demotivated. Sooner or later, things catch up. It is a hard fact, I'm saying again, there are biases at work. Let's not get demotivated by them. Let's just put in our best. Let's figure out ways to cope with them, deal with them, and speak up. Yes, that's my final point on managing biases. Women grow up being a little coy, a little shy, over-modest about their capabilities. They usually don't brag. I'm not saying you go out and brag, but learn to market yourself. Speak up when needed. If there's a good meaty assignment that excites you, don't shy away, ask for it. You may or may not get it, but you'll at least come across as a person who's eager to do more, who's eager to deliver. And if you're early on in your career, do not shy away from travel. Do not shy away from an assignment far away from home, because this is your time to pick up a lot of skills which will come in handy later. So really wishing all the women out there the very best. If you have any further questions, you want me to talk about something else, do email me at richa.corporatediaries@gmail.com or drop in the comments. Thanks a lot.